Photons are oddballs. When they're not busy being waves, they are massless particles that can travel at light speed because, well, that's what they are, little packets of light. For decades, it was also thought photons didn't interact with each other at all, but recently researchers have discovered how to bind photons together as though they were molecules. With flashlights, unlike with ghostbusting equipment, you can cross the streams all you want. Photons don't bounce off of each other or cause every molecule in your body to explode because photons don't much care for one another. Unless, that is, they're fired through an ultra-cold cloud of rubidium atoms. When scientists from Harvard and MIT fired a weak laser through a rubidium cloud, they observed photons coming out the other side in pairs and triples. Not only that, but they could tell from how much the photons were oscillating that they weren't just bunched up together coming out of the cloud. Oh no, they were bonded, like molecules, photonic molecules. They could even tell how strong the bond was based on their oscillation frequencies. But before we get too ahead of ourselves, I should tell you that this is not all new news. Back in 2013, scientists fired a blue laser at ultra-cold rubidium gas and observed the photons forming pairs when they came out the other side. What's new this time are that the photons formed trios. Scientists weren't sure if it was even possible to form groups of three interacting photons. And it turns out not only is it possible, but three photons interact even more strongly than the pairs of photons. To explain how this happens, researchers believe that as the photons travel through the rubidium cloud, they are briefly captured by the atoms to form an atom-photon hybrid called a Rydberg polariton. The photon travels from atom to atom doing this, and if two polaritons come close to one another, the photons can mingle thanks to their atomic partner. They become entangled, and when they reach the edge of the gas cloud, the atoms stay behind while the photons stick together. It's sort of like two shy people being introduced to each other by their more outgoing friends at a party. Normally, you know, they would never approach one another on their own, but once they meet, they really hit it off, and apparently, they're even cool with adding a third person to the mix. I'm gonna actually stop this metaphor before I get in trouble. These new photonic molecules have interesting properties as well, like taking on tiny amounts of mass, which is crazy because, you remember, photons by themselves are normally massless. They also travel about 100,000 times slower than normal, so, you know, sluggish 10,000 kilometers per hour. What we can do with these photonic molecules remains to be seen. They could make it possible for computer logic gates to use light instead of inefficiently converting light to electrical impulses and back again like they do now. Or they could be used in quantum computing to carry information thanks to their entangled state. Or if adding more photons to the mix makes them interact even more strongly, it might be possible to make entire crystals out of light. Time and more research will tell, so more research is needed. Be the light of our life, take a sec and subscribe. Speaking of quantum craziness, did you hear scientists teleported stuff to space? A handsome devil talks about it right here. While photons in the visible spectrum usually won't interact, very high energy photons have a higher probability of bouncing off of one another in a process called gamma-gamma scattering. Thanks for absorbing our photons into your eyeballs. We'll see you next time.